to the Martians and Venusians watching today's episode. I'm your host, Mademoiselle Venus, and I'm here to talk about the INTPs and the ISTPs and their fixation. And what do I mean by fixation? It's the thought that is constantly drumming in their minds, right? They're obsessed with this thought. It is the thought that all of their psychological energy is kind of funneled into, okay, whether they like it or not, whether it's voluntary or involuntary, it's just there, okay. They must feed their attention and understanding into this thought. So I think this is going to be the shortest video of the series, because the INTP and the ISTP is the way they think. It's pretty straightforward, right? And I know I said this before about ESTJs and ENTJs, because they're also thinkers. That's the letter T, the third letter in the four-letter code. That's what it stands for, thinking, right? So these four types are thinkers. They make all their decisions based on rational or logical thought, okay? And but ENTJs and ESTJs, the way they think, it's kind of, they go by the majority, right? If the majority out there says that all umbrellas are black, let's say 75 or 80 people out of 100, and let's say those 75 people were Harvard educated, then the information is correct, and it is going to be the truth that the ENTJ or the ESTJ is going to stand by, but not an INTP or an ISTP, okay? They are the true intellectuals. Carl Jung, in his book, The Psychological Types, referred them as the critics, okay? So they critique any incoming piece of information. It don't matter if you're Harvard educated, and it doesn't matter if 80 out of 100 people believe that all umbrellas are black. They are going to verify this information, okay? They are going to get this information and they're going to process it by asking questions. It's not so much about the statistics, right? Like how many people agree that all umbrellas are black. That is quantitative research. And INTPs and ISTPs do not focus so much on quantitative research. They do bring a scientific inquiry into the discussion, just like an ENTJ or an ESTJ. But an ENTJ or an ESTJ would resort to groupthink, to what the majority agrees on. And if the majority has the status, okay, the qualification, they're going to agree with that piece of information, but not an INTP or an ISTP. They don't care. They are going to go deeper. They're going to bring in that scientific inquiry. Why must all umbrellas be black? Okay, what is the logic behind this phenomenon, right? They're going to want to know the why, the what, not just the what, the why, the how, the when, all those types of questions. And in interacting with INTPs mostly and ISTPs a few times, what I've noticed is they tend to ask a lot of questions, okay? And it's going to be exasperating, especially if you're not one of these types, right? Because they're going to want to ask you these questions. They seek understanding. And that truly is their fixation or their obsession, understanding. And they have other fancy words, okay? So they... in the Myers Briggs community, a lot of people throw the word around like they are logical. And by logical, you know, you try to break it down into true or false, right? Or does this make sense to me? Or does this not make sense to me? But the way I like to understand their psyche is that they primarily ask questions to seek an understanding, okay? And so let's say you wake up one morning, okay, and you tell an INTP friend of yours that you're feeling better today. You know, most types would be like, okay, yeah, that's cool. And they would kind of overlook it, right? They're not trying to understand it more than what you say it is, right? They're going to take it at the face value, like you feel better. But an INTP is going to dig deeper. They are going to turn to you and ask you, what does better mean? Why do you feel better? What is it about last night's sleep that made you feel better? Okay, they're going to ask you all these questions. And you feel like when you're having these conversations with an INTP, you feel like you're moving at a snail's pace because they're trying to understand everything, okay? And that's why I said it could be exasperating because they invite you into these discussions and they start, it's like a psychological attack, okay? PA and panic, and it can induce panic sometimes because you're trying to understand yourself and truly, and this is what intellectuals do, right? They ask questions, they are curious, and INTPs are definitely some of the most intellectual types amongst the 16 personality types because when they ask you these questions, you almost feel that, are they stupid? Like, don't they get it? And actually, you're the one who's stupid because you don't get it. You don't even know what you're talking about. And it's quite a humbling experience because you think you know a lot of things, but you don't, right? And an INTP is going to show you that. And on a certain level, you feel that they're psychologically superior when they ask you these questions. And it is true, but I don't necessarily think they come from that place. I think it's not so much about pride or hubris, all of that, which you could experience with an INTJ. With an INTP, it's more about curiosity. They genuinely want to understand, okay, what is this word that you're throwing around that you're feeling better? What does that even mean? And they want to make sure that they have clarity. And you think that they are asking you these questions because they want to know what's going on. And they're interested in you, right? They want to know your mind. They want to understand what is it that you're talking about. And in explaining to them, you actually come to understand yourself better. And so this is a 5x5 experience. I would highly recommend, especially if you're an INFP, by all means, even if you have to stalk them, find yourself an INTP because they're going to rev up that self-awareness, okay? They are going to make you smarter because you try to understand yourself better. It's literally like peeking into the mind of God, okay? Because God knows everything. And it's not that an INTP knows everything, but they invite you into this discussion where you try to know yourself better and what you're saying better, right? You're trying to understand things, and the objective of any discussion with an INTP and or an ISTP is clarity. Okay, that's precisely what you feel when you have a conversation with them. There is so much clarity. There is so much understanding. There is so much sensibility. There is so much logic. And that's what these types are all about, baby. So the nugget that you really get out of any discussion with an INTP or an ISTP mind is clarity. And clarity is everything, okay? Now coming back to their fixation, or the way their minds work, right? Or the way their psyche works, if I have to use a fancier term than their minds or their egos, right? So yeah, they're primarily fixating on if things are sensible, if they can be verified, if they're true or false, okay? That is one way to look at it. But besides that, they're also looking for consistency. If you go up to an INTP or an ISTP and tell them that you're obsessed with books, you love books, right? They're going to ask you, when was the last time you read a book? And if you tell them, you know, that you read one, let's say 5 years ago, they're going to question that statement that you just made. It is highly inconsistent, right? If you love books, if you're obsessed with books, because what is love at the end of the day, right? It is kind of an obsession, right? So if you're truly obsessed with books, how's that possible that you read one like 5 years ago, right? Haven't you had the time to read one like just last month or last week? Like, how's that possible? Okay. So that's how they're thinking. They're looking at consistencies in everything. Things must add up. And another thing that I've noticed about INTPs and ISTPs is that they can come across as socially awkward, and rightly so, because if their psyche is devoted to understanding the truth of everything, if things make logical sense to them or not, they try to protect themselves from getting influenced by external by the external environment and the people in it, right? It's almost like they go into a shell. They don't want contradictory information, too much of it, right? This can create distortion in their minds. So as much as possible, they try to keep away from people. And it's not just that. It's just that because they are truth tellers and the truth is always harsh and the truth always burns, because for them dispensing the truth is more important than creating harmony, right? As it is for an INFP, we want to create that social smoothness, that cohesiveness, and that's not exactly what an INTP or an ISTP is going for, right? They'd rather tell you the truth, because what's the point of lying? And it's not so much that what's the point of lying. I mean, all lies must be burned away, right? And only the truth shall exist. And that is the code by which an INTP or an ISTP would live by or lives by. Folks, that's all I've got for today's episode. In this exploration of the INTP and the ISTP mind. If you found this content useful, if it helped you understand the INTPs or the ISTPs better, and by better I mean that if it brought you clarity, please like this video and subscribe to this channel, because I need subscribers to keep this channel going, right? And drop me your thoughts here, or just send me an email. The details are in the about section of this channel. Until then, love you, love me, love Mademoiselle Venus.